Welcome. First off, I want to start by saying how strong each and every one of you are. Walking through that door is never an easy thing to do. So at the same time, what is shared in this circle remains in this circle. So would anyone like to start? Michael, how about you?
I've heard obsession and depression don't mix well. Well, I've been living with both of them trapped inside a mental jail. And as the pressure mounts, it gets exhausting. But the thought of being vulnerable is haunting. See, I would much rather just sit back in this chair and listen to each one of you as you open up and share, because this is a waste of time. At least that's the way I feel, and I'm tired of being told this will all eventually heal from people who don't know what it's like being addicted. Your actions make you a villain, but inside you're the victim. I'm feeling hopeless. This illness consumes me. It's physically, mentally, and emotionally abusing. And to be honest, I don't know if I want to take another breath. I'd be a liar if I haven't contemplated my own death. Thoughts of pressing a blade tight up against my wrist or pointing a gun in a spot that can't miss. And I'm ashamed with myself, but these thoughts live like an evil seed. And when I try to rip them out, they bury deeper underneath. More shame and more grief that make it hard to breathe. But I've lived with them for so long, they become a part of me. But the worst part of it all isn't how you can live with what you do. It's how it affects the ones you love and the ones who love you. But I really do wish there was a way that I could reverse the time, hit pause and then rewind and take back what was mine. But I can't, so I'm left with wasted years, a prisoner to the fear, pedaling through life on a bike with broken gears. But I've had enough. I'm done with drying eyes. I'm sick of fake smiles that I'm forced to hide behind. I'm ready to make a change, put an end to all the rage. But how can I ever turn the chapter with my thumb stuck up on the page? It's time to finally let go. I guess I'm asking for a hand to help walk me down the road. And as I look around the room and stare into all your faces, I can see that I might actually be in the right place to open up about what I'm feeling. Maybe strength and community has always been the key to healing. There's an energy in this circle, and it's made this doubter start believing. So I'm done with being silent. I'm done with making excuses. It's time to stick together, because when we're together, no one loses. Create a space that's free of judgment, where we don't have to fear nothing, and promise to always lend a hand whenever someone needs something. So thank you all for what you've given me. A place to clear my mind with a group of people actually listening.
Michael? Michael? Would you like to start?
Yes, I would.